like to welcome you to today. Today. Coffee! And a delicious smoke with me, the A-Bomb. Well, the LWO Network looks like it's running strong. Congratulations, Uncle Lou. But before I go on, I got to give a shout out to Farmer Jacob and Anthony Passo, my brothers, from not only the Passo Garage, but from the Twisted Style Channel. Now, about a year ago, Farmer Jacob started the Twisted Style Channel, and he asked me to participate in it, and it was a channel that was supposed to have multiple video makers on it talking trash in the Trash Talk circle. Now, that's cool, and it didn't really work out for us, but we all came out smelling like roses anyway. I did quite well here on YouTube on my own, and Farmer and Passo, they got two epic radio shows, one of them I'm a small part of, on Radio AFS. The Passo Garage and the Beating Drum, and the Passo Garage, which is on Tuesday, 6:30 p.m. Pacific. Okay, it's on Radio AFS. It'll be on AM radio in April. It's going to be syndicated. Congratulations to you guys. Now, I want to get to the purpose of this video, okay? And a reason, my reason is because of my friend, 8 Camel Toes. And the man is a friend of mine. We met because of YouTube here. We talk on the phone every now and then. We got a lot in common, believe it or not. We really do. I'm actually wearing my tie-dye shirt for him. And I know he can appreciate my space hat. But 8 Camel Toes, he recently made a few videos. A few videos concerning another guy I like named D-Town. And unfortunately, 8 Camel Toes, he went way out of character for who he is with those videos. Made him look real bad. And he's only done this one time before when somebody accused him of flagging their videos down. And that time, he also looked bad. Now, why did he look bad? Well, same reason I looked bad when I was on the Twisted Style channel. When you make these videos on YouTube, people can spot a fake. They can spot when you're not being yourself, when you're trying to pretend that you're something you're not. Now, I had to kind of evolve into the A-Bomb character, and the A-Bomb is a character. I'm Art, okay? My name's Art. I'm actually a nice little guy, little fat guy, I live in Stockton, California. But the A-Bomb is a character that was invented by Farmer Jacob, Anthony Passo, and I. And the A-Bomb's supposed to be boisterous and loud, offensive, and, you know, I can be like that, you know, but it's not the only part of me. It's not my only side. It's not even my best side, but it's something I enjoy doing. With the A-Bomb character, you know, I'm able to just get a lot of anger and just release it. And the fact that I release it here on YouTube means you get a chance to laugh about it or get mad or whatever. Now, D-Town, he is one of these guys. He's one of these guys that will do almost anything on YouTube for a laugh. Whether it's him and Roby Red's faking Roby Red's death, or it's him exposing private messages from Slitta about going to see a prostitute. D-Town is an epic puppet master. He's somebody that gets other people to make videos that he wants them to make. And what 8 Camel Toes did was he played into D-Town's trap. Played into it. Now, D-Town can do it with a comment, or he can just say something in a video. And the man's done it to me. He has. But the difference between 8 Camel Toes and I is, I react better to the stuff. And I take it for what it is. It's the man's fun. Okay? Now, 8 Camel Toes, he doesn't have what it takes to relate to that or to participate with that in him. He just does not. What makes 8 Camel Toes enjoyable is that he's a hippie. He's a hippie from North Carolina. which is funny in itself, okay? And, you know, he'd get on YouTube, he'll talk about his life, he'll sing a song, he'll trash talk for his Carolina Panthers, and it's enjoyable to watch because it's him. It's genuine, okay? Just like with D-Town, what he does on here, however hate-filled and maligned it is, it's him. And that's something I had to learn, okay? When I first came here on YouTube, I wasn't me. You know, I was putting on an act that really didn't work out. And, well, I started my own channel, okay? And I just started being me. And the audience liked it. And people started subscribing, and I would offend people and a channel would get flagged down. This is like, I don't know, I've had like 6 or 7 channels all told. And, you know, now I'm on the LWO network, and this is just for the LWO network. And I started being me, and I started making friends, and I started, you know, doing well and having more fun with this. So what I'm going to tell all of you is, if you're going to make YouTube videos, be yourself when you do it. If you put on an act, if it ain't you, people will stop watching. I mean, if you look at Eat That Pussy 445. Okay, now as a fan and a member of the TTC, the Trash Talk Circle, I absolutely despise the man. I do. But what he does, and the reason he has 70,000 plus subscribers, is because it's him. That's who he is. It might not be who he is in real life. Maybe he's a quiet, shy guy. But when he's on YouTube, he reveals a part of himself that's real, okay? Now, for those of you that take this YouTube stuff real serious, I got news for you. This is not reality. Far from it. Uncle Lou has said it. Even D-Town himself has said it. This isn't real. Now, mind you, we enjoy what we do, and I celebrate that I was named the Trash Talk Circle Rookie of the Year. But honestly, did it get me anything? No. It just gave me something to talk about and have fun with. That's all it did. Now, I do appreciate it, don't get me wrong, but at the end of the day, I'm just happy people enjoy my videos. And that's a fact. Now, Uncle Lou, he's in the same boat. Uncle Lou knows that the LWO, NWO thing in the Trash Talk Circle, not real. And Uncle Lou has a lot of fun on here. But one thing that comes through in all of Uncle Lou's videos is that it's him. Whether he's in character or very seldom out of character, it's him. Now, for those of you that don't realize things, the A-bomb is a creation. Yes, it's me. A lot of what the A-bomb does and says, it comes from me. But not all of it. Some of it's just character. It's make-believe. It's fun. But it is fiction all the same. For those of you that take the A-bomb too serious, my advice to you is get a life. Get a life. I mean, if you can't participate in the rolling and ongoing joke, if you're not laughing, you shouldn't be watching the videos. I mean, I go at people. People come at me. And I have a lot of fun with it. When I was a kid, we called it capping. Or bagging. You know, and it evolved into shit talking. Trash talking. I started doing it with sports, you know. When I played sports and, you know, being a 49er fan. Everybody likes to talk trash. And everybody thinks they're good at it. Well, I am good at it, and I have a lot of fun with it. But unfortunately, you get some guys like Jamal Seaton. That's not very good at it. And he thinks he is. And those guys, well, those are guys we have fun with. And then you get guys like 8 Camel Toes that are interesting without the trash talk. That are just interesting people. And then they get into something that they shouldn't. And that's what happened to the man. Now, I like 8 Camel Toes. I gave him a call. We talked about it. I've had to call him on one other occasion, you know, with stuff like this, saying, hey, man, you know, you need to chill out. So that's what I'm telling all of you to do. Okay? If you are personally offended, if something on YouTube gets you so mad, maybe you need to quit watching. Maybe you need to not participate. And if you're making videos and you're faking it, people are going to know that. They're going to see it. They're going to read into it. Even a good actor or actress has something of themselves in every performance. So anyways, I am the A-Bomb. Smoke's about over. Coffee and a Smoke with the A-Bomb on the LWO Network. See you tomorrow.